today is gonna be a bit different. We are going to, I am going to take you with me on my mixing process. Some of you may have noticed that lately I've been receiving a lot of cells in my paintings, and you all know I'm not a fan of silicone and don't really want that in my paintings, but I find my ways to get at least some cells if I want them sometimes. So my latest demo, the Ocean Pour, I got a lot of lacing effects and also pretty many cells, just nice cells, not overwhelming, but for me perfect match, perfect blend of cells and non-cells. So I got a question from one of my viewers. If that depends on the paints that I'm using, and she was working with the Amsterdam paints and Fluorotrol, and she wasn't able to get any cells. So today we are going to try with some Amsterdam paints and with my latest technique and see if I do get any cells with that. So yeah, a bit different, and I hope you enjoy it. And so I do shake my Fluorotrol well, but even if I'm shaking, I know there will be bumps in it. So I always have my little soaking every time I do this. And I forgot my glasses, and I am really not very useful without them, so I'm going to get them. Okay, so I always start my mixing with the Fluorotrol. I don't know whether that makes any difference, but that's the way I do it. When I started this art, I did add the paint first, but I found it really hard to blend it and mix it well then. So we are going to work with three colors today. It is the Amsterdam Sky Blue Light, and it's Amsterdam Turquoise Blue. And I didn't have any more paints in Amsterdam, so for my base and negative space, I will use the Basics Mars Black. And I do, if you see here, I can see where my Fluorotrol ends. So I take about half of that amount with the paint and fill it up to there. So that was the Sky Blue Light. And this is the turquoise, and I do the same with that one. And then the black. So this is two parts Floetrol at least, and then the black. I don't take that much when I'm working with the negative space. I don't use that much paint really. It's more Floetrol than paint. So. So with only about two parts Floetrol and one part paint, this is the consistency, and that is way too thick, of course. So I will have to water this down a bit. Also, I will need my long spoons for the black. So I will just go on now and hope you will follow me. I just add a little bit of water at a time. These are not really that heavy, but if you add too much water, it could be hard to blend them. So I just do it like this. They are really easy to mix these Amsterdam paints, and they look shiny as well. Looks really pretty in the cup actually. I think it's a little bit too thick still, so just a little bit more. This, I think, looks starting to look as I like it. It's mounting just a little bit in the cup, not too thin. Yeah, I could mention that all this plastic and the garbage that we make in this art is actually bothering me a lot. But I have a fireplace outside, so maybe once a month I will add the fire to these cups. And as this summer, there was so heat and dry here in Sweden, so we weren't allowed to barbecue or make fires, not anything. And then I left all this plastic garbage in the environmental station here in the community, and they will handle them for me in a good way, hopefully. So I don't put anything of this in my own garbage. I really don't want it in that. And this negative space or base color, I do mix pretty thin, thinner than the other paints. And also this, the black is not that heavy color, so when I use the black, I actually want to achieve the veins when the other colors go down in the black color. I really like that effect. this I really don't want to mountain at all when I do this. I just want it to disappear directly into the other color. I think this is good for now, before I make my dirty cups that I will be making today. I will check up on them again, but in the meantime I will prepare my canvas and we'll be rolling. So my canvas is getting ready. I put some tape under here and also this so it can stand. And I haven't gessoed this because this canvas is gessoed already. And I just spray some water on the back and leave it like that for just a few minutes. And it will be really good to work with. It's a really rainy day here in Sweden, and the lightning is not very good today, so normally I wouldn't film in this bad conditions, because my windows are too small and doesn't let enough light in, so I have a lamp over my working area today, and that also means that the colors will not be correctly, they will change in the film. So I don't like this lightning. I like natural light. As a photographer, that's what we work with. So, but hopefully this will go okay. Yeah. Well, my intention when I started out this was to have everything in the same demo, but I feel it's too long, so I decided I would cut them into two different demos. And that way you can also choose only to watch the painting. So for those of you who want to follow me further with this one, please look up for part 2 of this demo. See you there!